Hey guys, Caden with Leading Edge Equipment here. Today we're going to go over setting up turn automation inside of your Gen 4 or G5 display. As you can see here, this one's equipped with the G5. It's a little bit bigger screen, a little bit brighter, a little bit quicker, but this feature is also available inside your Gen 4 machines as well. So the first thing is I have the hot key on the bottom for turn automation, but if you don't have that, hit menu. And then once you're inside the menu page, we're going to go over to applications. From applications, we're going to go to the AutoTrack turn automation screen. So once inside of here, if it's off, you'll just toggle it on. From there, it'll give you a status, okay? So if you click into that status, if something is not complete, it will let you know. The main thing that's more than likely not going to be complete is the headland, okay? So you have to use boundaries. So if you hit this, this will actually bring you into your fields and boundaries boundary page. And what it does is, again, you need to have the boundary. So if you got to create the boundary, go do your headland and create a boundary off of your headland pass, your headland work. But then you'll have to come in here and you'll actually have to tell it what headland you want. So I'm going to do a constant offset. I have a HD50F equipped and I'm going to do two headlands. So I'm going to put it at 100 feet, okay? You'll see the little dotted yellow line. That's what you want. If you just want to do a top and bottom offset, that's completely fine. You can do it that way too. I'm just doing a constant offset for this video. From there, you're going to hit save. And now you'll see it's ready. From there, we're going to actually go back and we have a couple more options, okay? So what we can do is change the turn size. And what this does is it allows how much of a rounded off turn versus more of a U-shaped turn happens, okay? So the smaller you go, the more U-shaped, the larger you go, the more, I guess, rounded off U-shape it would be, okay? There's also this equipment turn settings down on the bottom. By default, it is a 22 minimum turn radius, okay, 22 foot. Down on the bottom here, you have these different spiral out and spiral in. Okay, so this is how many passes you can do. And this is a different spot. I'll show you guys where you can do a couple different types of turns, but that's where you would customize that. And then there's this allow turn with auger extended. Just be aware, if you have this on, the turn automation will continue the turn even if your unloading auger is out. So if you have any head power lines or anything over the head of the combine that it might get caught in the unloading auger, be sure to have that off. It'll pop up a warning that, hey, you have to take over control of the wheel because the unloading auger is extended. If I'm gonna back out of there, there's also this start turn, okay? So what this is gonna do is based off of where that dotted yellow line is from that headland that we generated, where do you want the combine itself to start the turn automation process? Do you want it to start before that yellow dotted line, or do you want it to start after that yellow dotted line? This would be more into the headland. This would be more out in coverage in the negative, okay? What that's really there for is just customizability based off of, hey, did I truly get a good 100 foot headland, right? Maybe I actually only got 98 feet, so maybe I don't want it to start until 7-8 feet afterwards because I got room to turn around, right? Or maybe I actually did a smaller headland and I used two bigger headers, right? So I started earlier. This is just completely up to you guys how you want to customize it, what works best for your turning and your operation. So I'm going to close out of all of this. It's now set up to go. I'm going to click on my map page. You'll see this dotted yellow line out here now. Let's say you have too small of a headland, right? So I'm gonna go back in to my menu, my applications, my fields and boundaries, and I'm gonna adjust this headland, okay? So I'm gonna click into my boundary, and then I'm gonna click into the boundary again, and I'm gonna adjust this headland, okay? I'm gonna turn it down, and let's just say I only wanna have a 50 foot headland, right? And then I hit save. So over in the top right-hand side of the screen here, you'll see this pass to pass, okay? And that's got a zero. You may get a warning message when setting it up saying that it does not have enough room to turn around, so it wants you to skip a pass, okay? If you accidentally hit accept and you didn't mean to, what you'll see here is a one, okay? That means it's going to skip a pass when in the headland. So it's gonna go from here over to here, and then the next time it's gonna skip again. It's more of a back and forth type of pass, okay? So if you click into the arrow here, here's your different options, okay? So if you do have that extra pass, if I click left again here, you'll see it's saying I'm going to skip that pass and jump over one more. If you want to get away from that, just tap the arrow in the opposite direction. Okay, so it's skipping to the left an extra pass. I'm going to click right one, and now we have our single pass. Okay, so that's the first part. Also inside of here, on this left hand side, you have this turn type selection. Okay, so right now we're doing U-turns. We're in soybeans, so we're going to do U-turns. Well, what some guys like to do when they get to corn is always keep the auger on the inside. That's where you could start in the middle and spiral your way out and make sure that your auger is always on the inside. Or if you start on the outsides, you can spiral your way in. This is where you can select that turn type. And that also correlates to how many passes, again, when you go back into the advanced settings, you need to tell it how many passes for spiral out, spiral in. So as we approach the turn, you'll see down here on the monitor, the auto turn has the blue spinning wheel saying it is in action. Up top, we are approaching our headland. At this time with combines, the header you will have to raise manually, but you lift up the header, you will approach the turn, it'll start turning on by itself. As you come through and complete the turn, once you get squared back up, you can hit your number two or number three button to put the header back down. And then as it comes down and you enter your turn, you'll see it automatically swapped over. So that means now when we get to the other end, it'll do a right turn and then it'll go back, do the left turn again, so on and so forth. If you ever need to adjust that, just tap this button up here again and switch it right or left. So with that, it should cover most of the turn automation. If you guys have questions, please reach out to us at Leading Edge Equipment, and we appreciate your business.